I have learned two things in this life. The first one is, if your TV or movie series is successful, then it's gonna have a second season or a second movie, and unless your name is Shrek 2, then the second product is gonna be worse than the first one. And yes, I know I'm repeating myself, but I feel like I wanna get that point across with some better colored hair. So, with two new seasons of Total Drama being announced, I've started this series on Total Drama to list off 50 things right with every season. Today, we're gonna be looking at Total Drama Action. As I've stated many times on this channel, this is not particularly my favorite season, but somehow, thanks to you guys, I've managed to find 50 things right with it. So without further ado, sit back, relax, and enjoy as I list off 50 things right with Total Drama Action. Well, to start off, it's not all stars. That's it. The premise of movie genres was actually good. Challenges were almost all, if not all, kinda cool. Million Dollar Babies looked amazing. The Chris Anthem. The comedy was actually pretty great. Out of all the seasons, this was the most shy from using toilet humor, I think. Lindsay being happy for being on a team with Trent. They are good friends, I like that. Lindsay being the leader. I actually wouldn't see her being one, and I'm sad she never won a challenge for her team. Lindsay winning the challenge in Get a Clue against a group of people who turned their backs on her. Actually, can we just say that Lindsay and perhaps Harold were the only good things this season and leave it at that? Because I'm gonna come back to Lindsay many times during this video. No? Well, okay. Even if they did a terrible job with writing the characters, at least they did an okay job with writing and designing the aesthetical terms of this season. Justin had dialogue that didn't involve telling him how long he had his pants. Well done! But seriously, it was very nice to see Justin getting a second chance at being a character. It was nice to see him falling in love with Courtney. The facilities where they eat and sleep are also cool looking. The trailers just look so comfortable.
Si, muy caliente!
How we love misspelled Spanish in English broadcasts. Even if she did a terrible job at being the villain, Courtney was in top shape this season and it was nice to watch her. This confessional is just everything. In spite of them having no purpose for the narrative of this season, aftermaths were actually pretty cool and well written as well. They have comedic value to them, but in order to understand them you have to watch this season. Kind of a nice bang for your buck if you ask me. It's nice that they didn't left out the good old cast members that didn't make it into the act. Lindsay was in top shape this season and was even funnier. I'm gonna be honest, seeing her win challenges was so cool. Never thought she had it in her. Speaking of top shape, Harold was so much better this season, he deserved more. This season is not Pachytale Island. Well done! Heather embracing her baldness. Or her lines about afros and baldness. I'm sure that if we didn't have action, we wouldn't love Heather's character like we did in Total Drama World Tour. In fact, if we didn't have action, World Tour wouldn't have been so cool. Okay, Chris and Chef had already a very cool dynamic, but now it's just so amazing. Duncan and Courtney had such a fun relationship here. Harold taking no shit from Duncan was actually pretty cool as well. Beth's redemption was, well, not perfect, but great. The titles were all inspired in movie names, each of them more creative than the last. The pandemic challenge had a new meaning since 2020, as LaShawna Jr. left the tent now that we are in 2021. This season is one of the reasons why we need hashtag justice for Lindsay. Man, that's a good thing, how? Hohen's hallucinations. The robbery scene had some pretty slick music. The finales in Canada and the USA were broadcasted on the same day. The nations must have been stopped. All things considered, and even though it wasn't the most fast-paced one, the finale was oh so entertaining. The joke of Duncan guessing what color is Courtney thinking right now. Just brilliant, brilliant. Courtney's meltdowns are hilarious. Courtney is able to kick the living schnoz of two sharks. What a woman. Even if Rock and Rule had one of the crappiest endings to episodes in the history of this show, at least it had the coolest challenge. The fact that they are shamelessly and consciously mixing Kung Fu and geishas into an Asian-style movie challenge is actually hilarious. Courtney's song is brilliant. Every time we get to see Emily Claire Barlow sing, I'm happy. Why yes, I am a simp for this woman, why do you ask? Although incredibly pointless and a bit out of context, the 16 reference was just immaculate. And the most important thing, the reunion special just did everything. I mean, everything. It's one of the best episodes out there of Total Drama. I didn't count it in my top 10 favorite episodes because it's just a special episode. It's not a normal episode. That about wraps it up. I want to thank my follow subscribers for helping me come up with this one, but I think I won't be needing your help for future seasons. I want to tackle All Stars on my own. But then again, All Stars is several forevers away. Okay, bye.